knows a lot about all kinds of stuff. Professor Dave explains.
Now that we know what differential equations are and how to classify them, it's time to start solving them. Similar to how, in algebra, the type of equation will determine what solution methods are possible, the same is true here. The simplest type of DE is the separable differential equation, which is anything that can be written in the form g of y dy equals f of x dx, where y is an unknown function of x, and f and g are general functions. If we have a differential equation, where on one side we have dy dx, and on the other side we have a fraction of a function of just x over a function of just y, then this will be of the correct form, and this equation will be separable. If we treat dy dx like a fraction of the quantities dy and dx, we can cross-multiply to get our separated form. From here, integrating both sides will lead to the solution for any separable equation. Let's see how with an example. Consider the differential equation dy dx equals 1 plus sine of x all divided by 15y to the fourth power. The numerator only contains x, and the denominator only contains y, so this will be separable. Let's cross-multiply, which in this case means multiplying both sides by dx times 15y to the fourth to clear the denominators. We will be left with 15y to the fourth dy equals 1 plus sine of x dx. We are now ready to integrate, noting that the correct differentials are already there. We now have two integrals to evaluate, which should be very familiar. On the left, we'll use the power rule to get 3y to the fifth plus an arbitrary constant, call it c1. On the right, recall that the integral of sine is negative cosine, so we get x minus cosine of x plus another arbitrary constant, call it c2. Notice these two constants don't have to be equal, so we can't cancel them. Instead, what we can do is subtract c1 from both sides to get c2 minus c1 on the right-hand side, and say that a constant minus a constant is just another constant, so we can let c equal c2 minus c1 and just put c on the right-hand side. We have now obtained an implicit general solution to our DE, but we can easily rearrange for y by dividing by 3 and taking the fifth root of both sides to get the explicit general solution, y equals the fifth root of x minus cosine of x plus c, all divided by 3. In this case, we weren't given any boundary conditions, so we couldn't find the value of c to obtain a particular solution. Let's suppose we are now given the same differential equation, but now with the initial condition y equals 0 when x equals 0. This is like asking the question, of all the curves with the equations of our family of general solutions, which one passes through the coordinate 0, 0? I'm going to show you two different ways to solve this problem. The first way is to just take our general solution that we already know how to get and substitute in the boundary condition. It doesn't matter whether we use the explicit solution or the implicit solution to do this. And in this case, the algebra will be simpler if we use the implicit solution, 3y to the fifth equals x minus cosine of x plus c. Let's now set y equal to 0 and x equal to 0 because of our boundary condition. We get 0 on the left side, and on the right side, recalling that the cosine of 0 is 1, we get negative 1 plus c. Solving for c gives c equals 1, and now all we need to do is write down our explicit particular solution, which will be y equals the fifth root of x minus cosine of x plus 1, all divided by 3. There's another way to solve separable DEs with boundary conditions, and you may find it faster. Let's return to the step where we were about to integrate both sides in the previous method. We had just separated our equation to get 15y to the fourth dy equals 1 plus sine of x dx. We can now exploit the fact that when we integrate, we can use bounds of integration to eliminate the need for an arbitrary constant, and with a suitable choice of limits, we can incorporate the boundary condition at this step. If we choose the lower limit as our boundary condition, x equals 0 and y equals 0, while choosing our upper limit as the variables we are integrating, then the result will satisfy the boundary condition. All we have to do is evaluate these definite integrals to get an implicit solution, then rearrange to get the explicit solution, and we get the same answer as before. This works well when the boundary condition is simple and looks like y equals a when x equals b. It wouldn't work if the boundary condition was something else, and we'd have to use the first method. But using definite integrals is a nice way to solve boundary condition problems quickly, so be on the lookout for when it's applicable. Remember, you can use these techniques only when the differential equation is separable. When given an unfamiliar DE to solve, you should spend a few moments checking whether it is separable or not. Try to get familiar with recognizing when something can be separated. Sometimes it might not be so obvious, and you'll need to do some algebraic manipulation first. If in doubt, cross-multiply everything out and see if you can divide both sides by something to get all x's on one side and all y's on the other. Let's check comprehension. Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.